Hey kids, how are ya? Hey, I was talking to some friends down here. It's always great doing the Choral Festival, but it always feels like there's so many people, and the parking is so hard, and it always feels rather rushed and crowded. And it's nice to be back with just us again. So thank you for coming out. What a beautiful night. Oh my gosh. Sit back and enjoy. Jay is here, though. He won't be on the bandstand with us tonight. He couldn't make rehearsal. I thought about doing the gig with him anyway without rehearsal. No, we'll do it some other time. Well, we've got a great program. Very cosmopolitan. After last week's International Choral Festival, I got in the mood, and we'll do music from a vast survey all over the world, all over our country. But let's start with the Star Spangled Banner. Please rise. Let's sing together. It's evenings like this that we one of the reasons we live here in Missoula. Can you imagine a sweeter evening than this? A gentle breeze, just barely a cloud in the sky. The windows are open on the house, right? We all open our windows up and it's cooling down. Oh man. Is this why people live? Some places are like this all year long, but they're really not, are they? Not really, is it? Are there places in California that feel like this all year long? No, it's like 98 in the summertime, isn't it? If it could be like this every single day, we appreciate it more because of shoveling that stinking snow and the 20 below weather. So we appreciate get me going. Hey, Urban Rents is gonna be 93. Where are you, Urban? Where are you, buddy? Are you here? Usually there he is, look at that. Tomorrow, that gentleman is going to be 93. Will you please sing happy birthday? Roach is up at Glacier Park, and so I have to do double duty tonight. Hey, I'm Gary Gillette. I direct this band, and you also have to listen to me talk tonight. I'm sorry if I say something embarrassing or illegal. I apologize up front, so now we're okay. I've got a couple of friends who are officers, so they won't press charges. Hey, some of our members of the band have their favorites, and this is one of our favorites right here. Written by Claudio Garofalo, Yeah, that's right. Say that three times. A good immigrant. This is the favorite tune of our lead trombone player, Don Gesselbeck. Here are the Washington Grays.
Thank you.
I splurged and stopped by the Dairy Queen. I see they have 50-cent dilly bars on Wednesday evening. So I stopped by and chat. And I had a great little chat with a gal. She and her husband were there and standing in line. I thought, oh, you're here before. Oh, no. And they took a look at the poster in the window and said, hey, let's go to the band concert tonight. I wonder how it will be. And so I just kind of went, well, it'll be just great. And she said, now, how is it you pull that off? Because it's just Missoula people, right? That's right. We don't have, we've got a couple of ringers. But for the most part, we're just all amateur musicians. Now, amateur musician is not derogatory. It just means that we've only got two people in the whole freaking valley that are professional musicians, right? Jody Marshall, who really is a church musician now, and Dave Horgan, who married a college professor and can afford to play guitar. Thank you very much. The rest of us are all, we either teach music, a few of us, we're just amateur players, and the vast majority of the band behind you are folks that work real they have to go to work and work regular jobs and just love making music. How many of you have a real job you went to today? Look at most of them, huh? Hot dang, we're just regular folks up here. Hey, here's a three-movement work. It's a great work of American folk tunes. And if you're my age and older, you'll know all the tunes. And if you're 20 and younger, you'll have no clue what they are. You can learn, you can lean over to the punks next to you and say, well, that's Cockles and Muscles. Even Joel Holshoe knew that. Here is three movements. So if you want to act like you're real highbrow today, just pay attention. Don't clap between movements. You can look at each other smugly. Erie Canal, right? Erie Canal? Forgot the mic was on. I could use it in the midst of. The first tune you probably didn't know the name of. It was the sweetest one of them all, Shanty Man's Life. I didn't know it by title, but a shanty man. Do you want to know what that is? We used to have them around here. Loggers. Yeah, what a sweet little tune. Oh. Hey, you kids are so good at not applauding between. Hey, the symphony's not that quiet. Gotcha, Darko. Watch out, Driscoll's probably in the audience too. Hey, that's pretty good, wasn't it, John? Yeah, that's the executive director of the Missoula Symphony Orchestra. And because you're so good, I'll bless you with legitimate classical music. Huh? This is by Shostakovich. It was written for orchestra and then rewritten for band. It is absolutely gorgeous. Here's a simple march by Dmitri Shostakovich. Weather took just a twist in the last 5 seconds and blew a bunch of our music off the stands. We got spoiled and weren't having to clip our music into place. Thanks so much for being here again. Ron Scholl from MCAT, who's here every single week taking videos. Thank you, buddy. You're the man. And then during the winter time, we can all watch ourselves on the TV. Thank you, Ron. Hey, you'll know this one. Oscar and Hammerstein. It was a Broadway musical made into a movie in 1956. Shirley Jones sang the lead part. Gordon McRae sang the lead male. You know it yet? From the musical Carousel. Here is If I Loved You. My faithful and trusted assistant reminded me, hey, thank you so much for your support. We are sending out our wonderful assistants to help you dig down deep into your pockets. We appreciate your support. Thank you so much. Whatever you can give up, hey, Big Dipper's not here tonight anyway. And a Dairy Queen's only 50 cents, you know? So maybe it's time you start giving a little deep. Now, here's if I loved you.
Thank you.
If I loved you, look, the bad girls are still at it. You loved us so much, they're still busy. God bless you. Hey, now we left the Broadway stage and we've come back to Montana. There's some beautiful mountains over by the belts called the Centennial Mountains. And this Montana boy, Oscar Nygaard, wrote this march in commemoration of those great mountains. He was a native of Red Lodge, and we've been unearthing his music, and it's been played very little. The fellow who's been championing it is no longer in good health, and so we're digging back and finding this stuff, and it's great old Montana stuff. If you've ever been around Red Lodge, and they have the international parades, they have a great celebration early in the summer over there in conjunction with their music camps. This is a great march. Here is Centennial Mountains March. Hey, thank you. Come on back up, ladies. Thank you so much for going out and digging money out of those people's pockets. Pretty good, aren't they? All right, we're going to take a sideways glance. And you know, Native American music has been done by all of us white folks for so many years. And we got Hollywood drums. They just turned the snares off and played tom-tom. You'll hear a little bit of that, but just a touch of it. Both these are very respectful pieces of Indian culture into our white man's world of the concert band. You will know this tune, some of you old enough, Mr. Rentz, you'll know it from the 1924 movie called Rosemarie, starring Jeanette MacDonald and Nelson Eddy. It was on Broadway before then. Some of us younger folks know it from the soundtrack of Mars Attack. And the Slim Whitman arrangement, they figured out that it defended our planet from invading Martians. Here is dedicated two young ladies in our band. This is for you, Lily and Paige. Here's Little Indian Love Call. part of Nelson Eddy, Adam Steele, and Murray McCain. Thank you very much. I had to pull teeth on that one. That arrangement probably has been in the Missoula City Band books for 100 years and probably never been played, okay? That was all about Mars Attacks. How many of you know the scene at Mars Attacks? Oh man, you can Google that sucker, it's wonderful. Sousa was besides being the godfather of all marches and bands of America, was also very much an ethnomusicologist, and he wrote a song for Powhatan's daughter. That is Pocahontas to us folks that don't have the history. This is Sousa, man. Sousa writing this for us. Enjoy. Been all around I told you Cosmopolitan today. Now get ready, I've got a guest director. It's time for me to, you know, when Ron was here, you know, remember Tiny Dancer still is alive and well, but when Ron was always dancing over here, we all enjoyed his metaphysical exercise. He had a heart attack a couple years ago. He doesn't get up to Missoula much anymore, but I could always count on going out to Ron and he'd have a glass of wine for me. I'll just go dry tonight. This little director has been practicing, and this is probably his third year in a row. He's the son of one of our members, Corey, and Nick McAtee, who is most famous in town for getting my lawnmower back, and the father of little Alex. Please welcome Alex and our Rosencrantz du jour. Alex? This is dedicated to and conducted by Alex McAtee. Okay, I'm gonna, wait, I don't have a regular job. Oh boy, look at him smile now. And part of the rules is you don't act with kids or things like that. Oh man. Thank you, Alex. We'll see you at Tuba Christmas, okay, buddy? Okay. Hey, the Rents has just celebrated 71 years of marriage as well. My gosh, congratulations, sir. 71 years married? Man, you are going to heaven, buddy. And happy birthday to Carol Williams. Is Carol here? Oh, happy birthday Saturday, yeah, honey? You're not that, no. 3 years of 90. My mama is 95, so I have an appreciation for maturity. Hey, here's a beautiful Irish tune. You'll recognize some of the tunes. I hear Irish Washerwoman. Joel Hoshue guessed Cockles and Muscles. And you'll enjoy, this is Shalala. Thank you. you. Let's do one more. We uncovered it from the Blasting Cat boxes from Butte. The best band west of the Mississippi happened over in Butte for a lot of years, man. The company hired a lot of miners, but they also hired musicians. They wanted the best band in all the country to be there for the company. And there was a great band, a Boston and Montana band. And when they finally went defunct, they put all their music in Blasting Cat boxes, and we found it about 20 years ago. We've been unearthing it and smelling the gunpowder ever since. This is called Homecoming, straight from Butte. All you people from Butte, enjoy. Thank you so much. Next week, watch out, man. Gary Herbig is coming home. And besides doing Harlem Nocturne, you know, he's also will be performing Play the Bumblebee on flute. And if you don't know Gary, Gary is a local boy made big. He did the Hollywood Dream and moved to LA and practiced for 10 years. It took 12 hours a day. And Gary now is a pro musician in LA. And he comes home on vacation. And while he's here, I abuse him. Hey, here's Homecoming, kids. So much, folks. Hey, it's time to get going. Come on. 9 o'clock. I know it's time to take the meds. Come on. Let's go home. Thanks a lot, folks. Thanks for the sound, Jay. We'll see you next week. 8 o'clock. Happy birthday, Carol.